I'm genuinely so excited about this though. It's crazy. Welcome to another Impromptu Monday. Today, we're recreating the one, the only, the original cup noodle. Developed in 1971 by the legendary Mr. Momofuku Ando, who invented instant noodles in 1958. There are restaurants named after this guy and there ought to be statues built of him everywhere in the world. When I was a kid, these were the hard currency in primary school. You could buy someone's homework with it. Janet Yellen was still teaching economics at Barclays. So today we're recreating the original recipe, which was the chicken ramen from scratch. I studied the ingredients, and there are a lot of ingredients. And we narrow it down to three categories. Things we could improve, like the dry vegetables and the flavor enhancers. Things we just keep, like the ramen noodle, the salt, and things we completely ditch, like the preservatives. So, let's make the broth, shall we? First, very simple, we have the pressure cooker. Just to save time, you can use a regular pot. We have our poulet le breast, chicken from breast region, but you can use any chicken. It's a braising joint, at least with the legs. The prestige makes it such a common bird for roasting, but there are much better corn-fed roasting birds. So chicken in. And to replace all the flavor enhancers, which in essence, no matter how you phrase them, they are practically monosodium glutamate, MSG. We're gonna make a quick kelp dashi with nature's crystallized MSG. So this goes in, add enough water to cover everything, and we bring this to a boil. Once it starts boiling, we give it 5 minutes for the kelp to impart its umami, and then we take it out. We're replacing the dehydrated vegetables in two stages. One, during the soup making. Two, as garnish. So, add a carrot. An onion. I'm gonna explain my rationale on the ingredients in the description. I'm not gonna bore you with 30 plus ingredients. Onion goes in. Some garlic. In the original recipe, they use cabbage juice, but we're gonna use a bit of Chinese cabbage for sweetness, I suppose. We'll save the leaves for garnish later. The white part is what imparts most sweetness when you make something like wonton noodle soup. And replacing the sugar, we're gonna add some Japanese mirin. Again, the corn in two stages. Is there a maximum line that I'm breaching? I hope not. And of course, salt. All right, the kelp has had about 5 minutes to simmer. We fish it out, otherwise the soup becomes bitter. Pretty slimy, this thing. Now, we put the lid on, and we bring it to pressure. If you don't have a pressure cooker at home, just cook it for about 3 hours. It'll have the same result. I'll see you then. After about 90 minutes, the pressure cooker has depressurized. Now, we just open it. Be very careful. We have our wonderful, wonderful chicken broth with a lot of chicken fat floating to the top, which is perfect for our garnish. Now, we have our diced carrots, our corn, and the green part that we saved from the cabbage. To that, we add some chicken fat from the broth. And we let our garnish cook until the carrots are softened. We cook our ramen noodles, alkaline ramen noodles, in a pot of boiling water. And this is not my best work, but it will have to do. I hope they don't sue me for copyright infringement. That will really sour the relationship. There we go. And even though we replace the garlic and onion powders with real garlic and real onion, we're still gonna add a tiny bit of the garlic and onion powders. Just because from making fried chicken, I actually find them very flavorsome. And for the real experience, you kind of still want some granules dissolving. So we have the garlic and onion powders. To that, we add some shichime togarashi. We mix. I like to rinse them under cold running water. A, to give them an extra bounce, and B, to get rid of the alkaline taste. Of course, first, we have our noodles. We have our garnish. corn, a bit of carrots. Chinese cabbage. They have chicken meat in the photo, but that wasn't in the original recipe. Now, we add our granules to be dissolved. And the broth. Well, you can see the chicken fat floating to the top. It's brilliant. And of course, we replace the dried parsley with fresh parsley on top. And there you have it, the original cup noodles. Is it going to be as tasty as the real deal? Probably not, but I had a ton of fun making it. I really hope you enjoy. Wow, incredible. Don't even need wine.